Is there a real retinol killer? Is there a product that's better than retinol without the side effects of retinol or retinoic acids? A lot of people talk about it. A lot of people search for it. And there may just be something you should know about that works similarly and in some studies have had the same effect as retinols on the skin for skin tightening, fine lines, wrinkles, and even dark spots. It's called bakuchiol. Some people pronounce it bakuchiol, but we'll go with bakuchiol. Let me know how you like to pronounce it in the comments below. And remember, like these videos, go down there now, click the like button. It helps me bring you more videos like this. And in the comments section, let me know how you like things. And please feel free to share with everyone else your favorite products. It's all about learning here. Try bakuchiol, retinol's gentle plant-based sister for fresh, healthy skin. Many people do, and I know many of you like it. I did a short on it, and I heard some comments, so I thought, let's do a full video. Retinol is certainly, however, the gold standard classic for your skin. But here's why you might think about looking at bakuchiol. Retinol and retinoics are very well studied, but there are some downsides, as many of you know, and you watch my videos on retinols and my shorts to try and get you through all of the side effects and avoid the inflammation of the skin that it can cause. It can be quite harsh on the skin, especially when you first start using it. Your skin can go through this little phase where you get used to it, but you will always be playing with the dose depending on the season, the humidity, sun exposure, hormones, etc., etc. Not everyone wants that commitment, nor can they get to know their skin as well as others. Some of you here are very geeky and educated and love to do things for your skin and want to deep dive into all the science, and other people just want to throw something on, keep it simple, and keep cruising along without having to think about all the nuances about how your skin's going to react. Are you taking too much? Should it be used at the night, the morning? You want something simple. As well, there are places that many people should not use retinols. For many, the neck and the under eye, the skin doesn't have the oil production. It's just too sensitive. But there's been a new ingredient that are making waves as retinol's gentle sister, who works equally as strong magic without the strong side effects. Bakuchiol, it's a plant extract that beauty publications are calling a natural, less irritative, even vegan alternative. Some of you might like that. First off, what exactly is retinol and why does it work? We need to know that first. Retinol is the OG of skincare for dismissing wrinkles, fine lines, and dull skin. It's the third strongest form of retinol, a vitamin A derivative that promotes skin cell renewal and stimulates collagen production. Now, I say the third strongest. If you watch my retinol tutorial video, that's the complete length one, maybe 15 or 20 minutes, you'll know that I talk about retinol is the third. It has to convert twice to get to retinoic acid. Retinaldehyde, retinal is a product I like better than retinol. It's a one-step conversion in the body to retinoic acid, and retinoic is the number one most strong potent. Doesn't mean it's the best, because everyone's gonna be a little different for their skin. Sometimes the retinol is better for those with more sensitive skin. But anyway, we'll talk about retinol as the third strongest, because most of you are likely on retinols. It's more readily available. You do not need a prescription. All of them promote skin renewal and stimulate collagen production. Research shows 12 weeks of application of a retinol can result in smoother, firmer, all-around more youthful looking skin. Sounds good? Of course it does. Retinoids improve all things from texture, tone, hydration, hyperpigmentation, sun damage, and breakouts, so acne. Types of retinoids around, there are 5 types of retinoids, all of which have varying degrees of effectiveness. Retinol, like I said, the third strongest over-the-counter option, while tretinoin and tazarotene are available by prescription only. So it's harder for people to get them. And they used to get them from different countries. It's harder to get them with the import issues going on. So it's a favorable option for a lot of people, but it can also be too harsh for those with sensitive skin. Studies show the side effects can be quite serious, like burning, scaling. This ultimately leads to decreased consistency of use. Consistency is key. Skincare is no good if you don't use it. The best skincare is the skincare you're going to put on. These exact downsides are what lead to the popularity of bakuchiol. Is it too good to be true? Well, the up-and-coming bakuchiol is a plant extract that's said to have been used in Chinese and Indian restorative medicine for years. It's an antioxidant. It's found in the seeds and leaves of the plant Soralia cordifolia. That's a big one. But studies have shown that the bakuchiol helps prevent the fine lines and wrinkles, and with pigmentation, elasticity, and firmness. So it's all the things we're looking for. It works, and here's what I think most people want to hear and know, because now we know what retinols do. They're time proven, tested. People are used to them. But what I like about it is it works through the same receptors that retinol uses, which is why many refer to it as the natural retinol alternative. I've come to know it, as I'm going to tell you, through the anti-age serum and accelerator system that I give to all my patients, because in there's no retinol. Obviously there's growth factors and growth factor signals to signal the skin. There's no retinol, but there is bakuchiol. And that's how I've gotten to know the ingredient. More on that in a moment. It's and why I like the fact that it's a retinol similar product, because I can have them use this through their whole facial region, including the under eye neck. And a lot of the work I do is under the eye. It's clear that these similar results for bakuchiol are why it's giving retinol a run for its money. But what really gives bakuchiol the edge? Well, as previously mentioned, it's natural alternative. People like that. It's not as irritating, which is great because you can use it in different areas. And it's easy for people to titrate, to figure out what to use and how to use it, because you can use it daily. It's a great option for those who shop vegan, clean, and in consideration of skin conditions like eczema, psoriasis, and dermatitis. Bakuchiol is not a vitamin A derivative, and hence that means it doesn't have that irritating ingredient. So it is indeed the vitamin A, not the fact that it's hitting the same receptors, that gives it that irritating effect, the vitamin A derivative part. So it is definitely and distinctly different in that manner. A small trial confirms the results. In a study with 44 participants, those who used retinol reported more stinging, more harsh skin texture, and more kind of a burning irritation than they did with the bakuchiol. So it's proven to be more, I'd say more consistently used, but what I mean by that is less irritative and thus more consistently used. So don't discount that, because a lot of people pop off of retinols and maybe never go back, or never go back to something that hits that same receptor because of that vitamin A irritative effect. So should you make the switch? It comes down to you as an individual. This is a tough part with skincare. You need to know to your own skin and get to know it. Bakuchiol has that advantage of not causing the irritation. There really isn't any serious downside to using it. However, and this is part of the issue, it is unclear whether it is truly as effective as traditional retinol because of the lack of number of studies. There is are some studies out there now, not just in vitro or in glass, meaning outside of the human body, but there are some in vivo. There are some studies involving people prospectively with this, and we can look at one if you decide you want to know more about it. Just let me know in the comments. But it's not as well studied because there are hundreds of studies on retinol. It's going to take a while to get that amount of studies on bakuchiol. There's just not a lot of data as of yet, but it does look extremely promising. Now, it's in the anti-age system, and I mentioned that. The anti-age system has many things. You put the serum on first, and then you put the accelerator. The accelerator, or that system, The accelerator and the serum combination has niacinamide. It has peptides. Of course, human bone marrow growth factor. Not cells, not any active cells. And these are bone marrow growth factor taken from youthful people around the age of 19 to 21. And in culture, they just take a few of those cells and they culture them. But they have been tested for disease and illness. They're only the growth factor. Those are small signals that tell the skin to renew. The thing is, because Bakuchiol or Bakuchiol is one component of that, you can't say that it isn't the rest of the factors within that skincare that's making people look so young. But what I can tell you, people on that system, whether they're getting procedures or not, look phenomenal. They look younger. And that's why I insist, if they have a procedure done, they go home on it. And for those that might just be doing a few skin treatments or peels, or those that don't do anything, they have friends or family, I put them on that system. So whether it's the Bakuchiol or it is the growth factors or the combination, you can't quite know, but who cares? You know it works. The one thing I do know, they're using it under the eye and on the neck with no irritation, and that's what I like. Remember, you don't have to throw your retinol or retinoic away. You can use them at the same time in conjunction, and if you're using them both in the same day, you would use the anti-aging system first. The retinol would be your last step, because I want the growth factors to be your first most absorptive after your cleansing. If you want to use them, and this is what I recommend, alternately, so you could use one day on your retinoid, the next day on your anti-aging growth factor, and you can switch it up if you really want to get to know your skin. Twice a week for most people, if you're on a retinoic acid, so the first most potent is enough, twice a week for most people, and the other 5 days you can use the anti-aging system. So I let them mix and match, and I use them as their nighttime routine, because most people use retinoics and retinols at night. Use your anti-age at night. The anti-age doesn't have factors that necessitate one using it at the night. It doesn't have sun sensitizing factors, so it can be used in the morning, but it's just easier to use that system at night. It's not the least expensive skincare product. You get what you pay for here. But I like it to be on cleansed skin, no makeup, nothing else. Therefore, it reveals itself as a wonderful part of the nighttime routine. So if you want to know more on layering, just ask me the questions before or go to my skincare website for education and more videos. That is Bakuchiol. I love it. It's great. Are you using it? I want to learn from you guys. I think it's an amazing product. I put a complete playlist up here on skincare tips and products that you may enjoy.